Good afternoon. I'm Stephen Zobie. I'm the Director of Rural Activities here at the University of Puget Sound, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the Fall Festival of Choirs 2023. Before we begin, I have one quick announcement. One of our singers, Dan Greger, experienced an injury this week, and she won't be able to sing this concert with us, so we are grateful that Grace Placeta, flutist, will be substituting in for her for a duet in Voci's Sol Valsonova. So other than that, we acknowledge that this event takes place on the ancestral territory of the Puyallup tribe and the Lushootseed-speaking people, whose relationship with the land continues to this day. We respectfully acknowledge and honor the history and presence of Indigenous students, staff, and faculty here at Puget Sound. We, who are guests on this land, offer our gratitude for the opportunity to make music together here. The School of Music strives to recognize, include, and respect all of the peoples and musical traditions that make up our community. We hope you enjoy tonight's concert.
Thank you. you so much for being here this afternoon. This is Corral. This ensemble is open to the entire campus community here at the University of Puget Sound, and it's such a joy to work with these singers that come from really all different backgrounds. There's some non-vocal music majors, pianists, guitarists, flautists, and I think a trombone in the mix, guitar as well, so we can create our own band on the side. And of course, some non-music majors too. So the first piece that you heard was by Antonio Vivaldi, the first movement of his Gloria, which was actually written for an orphanage back in Venice, late 17th, early 18th century, for an orphanage of abandoned girls. And so as a modern-day conductor and musicologist, his original manuscripts were in SATV, soprano, alto, tenor, bass, voicing, but it would have been all girls performing this, so it's always a fun puzzle. Okay, who would have sung what, etc., one of those modern musical mysteries. The next piece for you, and in fact the next three pieces that we'll perform for you, also tie in with these ideas of truth, of justice, and peace. Gamaya is by Paul Rudoy, and it's a text in Sanskrit, and it's not in your program, so I'll go ahead and read it to you. From untruth, lead me to truth. From darkness, lead me to light. From death, lead me to immortality. Om, peace. And you'll notice in the middle of the piece, there's a very repetitious section where the choir is saying, Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Peace, peace, peace. And let that be a moment for you leaving the hall, etc., as that mantra for you as well, and wash over. Altlo Shalitivarim is in Hebrew with an adjacent text. The world is sustained by three things, by truth, by justice, and by peace. The African-American spiritual and turn protest song, Ain't Gonna Let Nobody Turn Me Around, also talks about things like injustice and sticking up for things that we know are wrong in this world. And we were really, really lucky to work with the particular arranger of this Ain't Gonna Let Nobody Turn Me Around arrangement, Dr. Anthony Teresa King, who is at the Handel and Haydn Society in Boston. And we were so lucky to have him on campus for the Northwest High School Honor Choir, and we were able to work with him on that. The final two pieces in our set, the first one is a New England sea shanty called The Wellerman, made infamous by this little-known website called TikTok, and then we'll leave you with a little Halloween spirit with a study of Double, Double, Toil and Trouble from Shakespeare's Hamlet. So enjoy the rest of Corral's set.
Oh, Oh, for our third song. It's probably one that many of you have heard before if you've ever watched The Greatest Showman. We'll be doing This Is Me. It was actually nominated for a Grammy, an Oscar, and a Golden Globe all in 2017, if you remember that. And it gives a message to the people that feel like an outcast or they don't really feel like they belong. You do belong, and self-empowerment for them. Enjoy.
Bye. Stop.
Reed Singers. This is the Audition Treble Ensemble here at UPS. That was I'm On My Way, arranged by Anthony Tresson King, who, again, we had the pleasure to work with here on this campus when he was playing in the Northwest High School Honor Choir Festival. And so I'm On My Way is a really interesting history. This particular arrangement was inspired by Mahalia Jackson, who's a famous gospel singer from the 20th century, and these spirituals were reworded, and some words had changed to properly fit the context of the civil rights era versus the time of slavery in which the folk spiritual tradition comes from. And so Canaan Land, in this instance, is referencing Canada. I'm on my way going north to Canaan Land, or Canada, when they would have been free back then. So we continue to honor African Americans and African American history in our next piece, Stardust by Lee Boykin. It's a really, really beautiful text that describes this ethereal description of stars and if we are stardust, but it very beautifully references specific people who are witnesses, or I shouldn't say witness, but rather victims of gun and police brutality. Violence. I just want to read you just a little bit of some of these lines of the poem and who they reference to in particular that you'll hear in this piece. Each day we greet another face. Maybe all this stardust will carry us home one day to a home where we can run. That's referencing Ahmaud Arbery. To a home where we can pray, referencing the victims of the Mother Emanuel shooting in Charleston. A home where we can breathe, George Floyd from my home state of Minnesota. And a home to sleep and dream without fear, referencing Breonna Taylor in Kentucky. Following Stardust, we hop on a quick plane ride over to Indonesia, to the island of Sumatra, where the song Rambadia comes from. It's of the Batak people in North Sumatra, and it's sung in Tapanuli, which is a local dialect. And Rambadia is all about greeting and trying to find out which surnames you have in the village. And there's just a strong solidarity in that piece, and a little bit of a teasing, playful sense as well in that. After Ramadia, we do a really beautiful cover of the classic Cyndi Lauper, True Colors. We're reminded that we are people who let other people's colors shine, and how we sort of recognize that in others as well. And then we hop on another quick plane ride to a pub in rural Scotland with mouth music, where this tradition of Celtic mouth music, it's really, really fast. There's lots of text that gets spit out. And back in times of poverty and religious oppression, these Celtic folks created this tradition in lieu of instruments because they couldn't afford instruments. And this type of music was used for dancing, for work, for filling up space in some way. So I hope you enjoy the rest of our set.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Pieces, O Praise the Lord by Ulysses Kay, from the middle of the 20th century, African-American composer from New York City, went on to teach in a number of institutions. The second piece that we transitioned into was by Jose Nunez Garcia, who was the top leading composer in Brazil. He was African Brazil, our Afro Brazil, and fabulous composer, not done that much in this country, but we put people in here one of his pieces, so we added that to our concert today. The piece we're going to do now is called Catch and Release. There's a little story behind this, I'll keep it short. This piece was written by Jocelyn Hagen, a Minnesota composer, Minneapolis, St. Paul based, and she wrote this in honor of the choir teacher at Central High School there, and in St. Paul, and she was struck by how students would come in year after year to this program and be affected in a positive way, and then they would go out of the program and spread that to the world. And she thought of her brother-in-law, who was a catch and release fisherman, and the same idea of just selflessly taking people in, turning their lives around, and sending them out. So that's what this piece is about, catch and release. And then our final piece, Some Nights, by the American band Fun. It's really not that profound. There's nothing profound about it. It's just a fun piece, so really happy about it.
Thank you. Some nights I stay a cashin' in my bad luck. Some nights I call it a draw. Some nights I wish that my lips could build a castle. Some nights I wish they just fall off. But I still wake up, I still see your ghost. Oh Lord, I'm still not sure what I stand for. Oh, what do I stand for? Oh, what do I stand for?
Most nights I don't know anymore.
This is it, boy. This is what. Again to check my style.
That's alright. I'm hard in my bed tonight. Shocks my bones for wandering. Just who I am.
So this is it? I sold my soul for this? I washed my hands of that for this? I miss my mom and dad for this?
The other night you wouldn't believe the dream I just had about you and me. Called you up and we both agreed it. It's for the best you didn't miss. As we keep our distance.
Okay, for our final piece concert, this will be all the choirs, so I invite all the choirs to come to stage. And if you are a former member of the musical program, we'd like to invite you on the stage as well to sing our traditional road poem. If you forget, we have copies for you as well.